tupeperushe bendera.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. Kabla sija zungumza, kuna vijana hapa ambao wanatoka kwa clan yangu. Naomba niwatambue, moja anaitwa Musyoka, mwingine anaitwa Mwasia. Wako wapi hapa vijana? That is Kevin and that is Kennedy. Na pia babu yao wako hapa, mzee ambaye alinizaa mimi. Hebu mzee asimame mahali alipo. Mzee asimame tafadhali. Pengine tuwapigie makofi, sio? Hey, hebu akuje. Mleteni hapa basi. Watu wanasema mzee aje hapa, sio? Nataka haja asije. Basi wajukuu wako amlete. Na huku akimleta, naomba niwashukuru sana ndugu wangu, ndugu zangu, Mheshimiwa Raila, Mheshimiwa Wetangula ambaye amemtuma ndugu Halwale, na Mheshimiwa Wycliffe Mudavadi, na wote viongozi wa CORD. Na aswa nyinyi ambao umetoka katika kila pembe ya nchi yetu. Sijui kama mzee bado hajafika. Nakuja. Najua umri pia upo, sio? Nadhani mlimuona kwa ile clip wakati nilikuwa nikisema kwamba nilikuwa na nimepigwa na kuwa homesick wakati nilienda shule form 1. Mzee amekuwa rafiki yangu sana. Na kama ambavyo unajua mama amelala. So, ni hapo tu. Wako na rafiki sana na huyo Mwasia. Thank you. Wiper. Wiper. As you can see, my wife, Pauline, is very well represented. And I know she's watching us. She has a slight challenge. And we thank God for what he's doing in her life. And I know a lot of friends are still praying with us. Fellow delegates, you have spoken, and I've heard you loud and clear. From Mombasa, at the coast to Moyale, to the north, from Garissa in the east to Kakamega in the west, Wiper delegates and members have made their choice known. Allow me also to recognize a very special delegation which has come, they actually arrived in the country only last evening from the United States of America. We want to recognize those special friends who are sitting behind us. Could you please, just as well wave at us? As you can see, they look like they come from Obama country. They're African Americans. And I want to tell them, welcome home. And others who have come from far and near, Fellow delegates, today I want to talk to you about my hope for the future and my vision for the kind of country we can build together. I'm speaking to you today against a backdrop of runaway corruption presided over by the Jubilee regime. The task ahead for the next president of the Republic of Kenya has been made a lot more difficult by an administration that cares little, if at all, about the greater good of the ordinary Mwananchi. There is a widespread and growing feeling of mistrust of politicians. Most Kenyans believe today that politicians are loud on promises but very silent on delivery. Most Kenyans believe that the political class is intoxicated with power. Most Kenyans believe that the Jubilee regime spends most of the time plotting and plundering. Most Kenyans believe that it is time for change. And most Kenyans, ladies and gentlemen, are right. There is an old saying, and I quote, that your words mean nothing if actions do not match. So I want to assure all of you here and the millions watching us on television, the millions following us on Twitter, the millions liking us on Facebook, and the millions listening to us on radio around our beautiful country, that my words today can and will be turned into action. But let me also say, a group of real, serious party adherents have even launched day before yesterday Wiper Television, which is also streaming this event live. But I must say, to succeed, we must all embrace change. Real, and I repeat, real revolutionary change. I, Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka, am the man with a vision for that change. I know what it means. I know what it looks like. And this is my story. As you have seen, I was born and raised in a remote village by loving but poor parents. They, and many others like them, lived as forgotten people, a people in the wilderness, far removed from the attention of government and civilization. 60 years later, too many Kenyans in a lot more villages remain forgotten people, deliberately denied hope for their future through the selfish behavior of the ruling regime. When I am president, they will be forgotten no more. Politics, ladies and gentlemen, based on arithmetic, tribal arithmetic, is evidence of a deficit of thought on the part of the proponents of such brand of politics. Banking on the tribe as the only tool for political mobilization is an insult to a basic principle of democracy as enshrined in our constitution, the freedom of choice and the right of association. We must fight tribalism whenever and wherever it manifests itself. And today, I want to be very candid on this issue of tribalism. We gather here today at a special moment in our country's history. Freedom, democracy, individual rights and liberties are under threat across Africa and in many places around the world. In Kenya, Jubilee has poured ice-cold water, fight for economic opportunity and social justice. But I have news for the forces of greed and defenders of the status quo, led by the billionaire hustler, the self-confessed hustler. The writing is on the wall. It is time for change in Kenya. It is time to change Kenya, and I'm the face of that change as I stand before you today. Today, ladies and gentlemen, millions of fellow Kenyans have lost hope for a job, and millions more work hard for low pay. Well, I believe there are at least two Kenyans who really deserve to experience a long period of unemployment, and we all know who they are, or don't we? Called, yes, on a mission to ensure that Jubilee will be Kenya's first one-term regime, and for good reason. They never won the presidency in the first place. And I wonder really whether you are able to hear me. Are the acoustics right? Are they right? Can you hear me? Thank you. The Jubilee regime has made corruption a way of life in its ranks. It continues to glorify impunity because its heroes take the trophy for the most corrupt state officers. It has taken tribal bigotry to new levels. The Kenyan people must rise up and reject the tyranny of Jubilee. Next year's election is about putting power back to the hands of Kenyans. It is about putting people first. You may be saying, that sounds good, but you are a politician. I think this is better. Why should I trust you? Today, as clearly as I can, I want to tell you who I am and what I believe in and where I want to lead Kenya. As a small boy growing up in a poor and marginalized part of Kenya, I remember my dear mother teaching me about family and hard work and sacrifice. My father was working in Mombasa.
I could drink a glass of water.
My father, whom we have just seen, was working in Mombasa like so many other men from our village. My parents endured the pain of poverty, hunger, and regular insecurity because they knew that their sacrifice was the only way they could support me and give me a better life. My mother, may God rest her soul in peace, held our family together through tough times. She taught me many lessons in courage against adversity. And always, always, she taught me to fight for what is right. That is why I will fight to create jobs so that parents can afford to raise their children today and in the future. That is why I'm so committed to making sure that every Kenyan gets education that changed my life and that my mother fought so hard to win for me. That is why I will fight to make sure that women in this country receive respect and dignity, whether they work at home, away from home, or both. When I think about opportunity for Kenyans, I think about my father who still lives in the village. He actually just came to be able to be taken to a medical checkup by his grandson, where I grew up. With the money he saved from his work, he opened a small dukkah in our village. He discovered that whilst he had never been taught to read, he could count. He turned this skill with numbers into a successful small business, and with the money he made, he was able to provide me, his son, with the education opportunities that himself had never known. My father showed me that with hard work can come opportunities, and I want the opportunities that were given to me to be possible for each and every fellow Kenyan. I learned a lesson from another person too, a person who for more than 30 years has worked hard to help our children by being a wonderful, loving mother and wife. That is my wife, Pauline. Pauline assured me that all children can learn and that each of us has a duty to help them do it. So if you want to know why I care so much about our children and our future, Pauline showed me the way. Our families have values, but Jubilee, I dare suggest, has none. That is why they lie to our children about giving them laptops. I want a country where all parents love and cherish their children. A country where children embrace and celebrate their parents. A country where every Kenyan child gets the opportunity to pursue and exploit his or her full potential. A country where everyone is someone. That is a Kenya we want. It is a change we all want to see. And I want to say something important to every child and teenager in our country growing up today under difficult circumstances. I know how you feel because I lived your life. I started with nothing except the love of my parents, and today, by God's grace, I'm a living testimony that with the family support and hard work and God on your side, you can make something out of your life. I say today, I say to you, don't let anybody tell you that you can't become the person you desire to be. And if other politicians make you feel like you're not a part of their family, come on, and be part of the Wiper family. African leaders must take full recognition of the demographic advantage and sincerely address themselves to the needs and aspirations of our youth. In Kenya, and I've said this on the screen, about 65% of our population is aged below 30 years. This group must be the catalyst for real growth. We must invest in them. I was raised to believe that hard work would be fairly rewarded. But you have seen corrupt politicians turn governance into a giant game of theft and plunder. That means that who you know and where you come from matter more than who you really are and where you are going. We must say no to that kind of narrative. For too long, ordinary Kenyans who try to play by the rules and keep the faith have been trodden down, laughed at, and exploited, whilst those who cut corners and cut deals have been rewarded. If you're lucky to have a job, you're working harder than ever, spending less time with your children, relatives, and friends, working nights and weekends, your income seems to be going down as commodity prices go up. And I checked yesterday. The price of 1 kilo of sugar has gone up in the last 2 days from 133 shillings to 145 shillings. That is leadership under Jubilee. The cost of education, the cost of healthcare, housing, fuel, and food are going ever higher. More and more of our people are facing poverty. Our people want change. The march for change has been hijacked by privileged interests. We must condemn and stop the horrible politics of corruption and give our people the government they deserve, a government that works for them. It is time for change, real revolutionary change. By all the indicators for economic and social development, Kenya is actually going backwards. And just about a year ago, we were judged number 3 as the most corrupt nation on earth. How is it possible that this beautiful country, so rich in human and natural resources, is fast becoming a poor country? How is it possible that our country, which should be a shining beacon of opportunity and hope, has become a country of despair for so many? The Jubilee regime has gone on a borrowing spree, literally auctioning our country and our people to international lenders. This is why we say today, any Kenyan born in our country on arrival has a debt to pay of approximately 80,000 Kenya shillings. I promise you that when I become president, we must renegotiate some of this term, some of these loans, to be able to avoid a total collapse of our economy. And that we must do in good faith. This is a hard reality. We have borrowed to the extent where the whole thing is not sustainable. In fact, economists do tell us that the government that takes over next year, the year 2018-2019, will be the crunch year. So many loans becoming due and payable. So if you're fed up with a government that doesn't work to create jobs, if you're fed up with a government system that seems to work against you and not for you, if you're fed up with watching the government increasing our debt pile and failing to invest in your future, then work with me to return Kenya to the path of progress for the benefit of all of us. For those who sincerely pay allegiance to the words of our national anthem and believe in the deep ideals of the black and the white, at this point I actually want us to raise those of us with the miniature flags, our national flag, to try and raise them. Are we together? How many are having those miniature flags? Naomba tupeperushe ili niwaelezeni kwa nini. Zile za taifa, bendera yetu ya taifa. If you believe in the black and the white and the red and the green of the flag of our republic, I offer myself to you as a true servant leader, ready, willing, and able to unite all Kenyans from all walks of life in pursuit of the ideas of a new Kenyan dream. It was from this podium in 2007, ladies and gentlemen, when I talked about 24-hour economy. And Kenyans thought I was dreaming. Today, that has become a trailblazer. We all know it is achievable. Jobs, education, security, healthcare, and the environment. These are not just words for my lips. The priorities of the government I will head must be right and clear. I will put the people first again. For example, the core leadership is truly united and committed to the eradication of extreme poverty in accordance with now internationally recognized sustainable development goals, and goal number one is on eradication of extreme poverty. But priorities without a clear plan of action, thank you, are just empty words. To turn these priorities into reality, we must change the way government works fundamentally. Jubilee has no motivation to fix government. It is time for us to realize that if we keep doing the same things over and over again, we cannot change for the better. If we really want to use government to help people, we have got to make government work again. Now, I don't have all the answers to the many challenges we all face, but I know, and you know, that the old ways are not working. Bureaucracies at both the national and, in some cases, devolved levels of government have failed. That is why we need a new approach to government, a government that offers more empowerment and less entitlement, a government that is leaner, not meaner, a government that expands opportunity, not the bureaucracy. When elected president, my government will pursue and facilitate a review of the constitution to be able to restructure devolution and allocate more resources to the devolved units. After all, that was a message when we ate tear gas along with my brother Raila and my brother Moses Wetangula. We were saying that Jubilee must, IEBC must go home. But we also saying Okoa Kenya. And the time to realize that objective is now. We were saying we'll strengthen devolution by allocating a minimum of 45% of the national budget to the devolved units. I shall personally champion the introduction of cabinet secretaries to the legislature and creation of deputy cabinet secretaries. Today, when Kenyan delegations go for international conferences, either they are represented at the level of the cabinet secretary or the level of the permanent secretary. I consider there was a serious omission. We do not have deputy cabinet secretaries, but I'm coming to that in a moment. To ensure inclusion and cohesion, I shall push for the reintroduction of premiership in a new structure of government that truly returns power to the people. This will be done within the first 180 days of my presidency. I mean within 6 months, in order to make this country deal a deadly blow to tribalism. Ladies and gentlemen, ukabila ndugu wa Kenya ndio umefanya kila mwananchi mwingine kutokuwa na imani na Mkenya mwenzake. I offer a people change based on Kenyan values. The choice is not Kamba, it is not Kikuyu, it is not Luo, it is not Kalenjin, it is not Luya, it is not Meru, neither is it Kisi. It is definitely not Maasai. Neither is it Gema, nor Kamatusa. It is Kenyan. It is different. And this time, it is new. It is change that will work for all of us. If we truly embrace each other as Kenyans and say no to the tribe, wa Kenya wenzangu, ukweli wa mambo ndio huo. Tangu mimi niwe katika public life, sijaona ukabila ukiimarika hadi kiwango ambacho umefikia sasa hivi. Na mimi naapa kwamba Mungu atujalie na Wakenya wenzangu wawe na imani na uongozi wangu. Mimi nahakikisha kwamba hakutakuwa ukabila Kenya hii, and I mean it. The problem is, you know, is lack of inclusivity. You saw where I come from. Unaona lile jiwe mahali ambapo mimi nilikuwa katika primary school. Nilikuwa natoka pale, baba huyu alikuwa ameni nickname bicycle. Alikuwa ananituma sukari dukani na kimbia kama bicycle. akaniita baiskeli. Nilikuwa natoka kwa hiyo jiwe. Na mimi siwezi basi mtu ametoka kwa jiwe pale sikumuona mtu mwingine. Ila umaskini na hapa basi. We must determine Kenyans. Are we a nation or are we a conglomeration of tribes? I am serious about this matter. It is time for the long anticipated revolutionary change. Nothing will stand in the path of change that is sweeping across the globe. And of course, people have said, I think Mheshimiwa Moja ameongea juu ya what happened with Brexit in the UK, what has happened even with the election of Donald Trump in the US. It looks like the world is going for change. The Gambia, never mind what the president said, President Jammeh, even after calling his opponent, congratulating him, 2 days later, he comes and says, it was not a proper election. It is, ladies and gentlemen, time for change. Jubilee must be crushed at the ballot on round one of the 2017 presidential poll. And I am ready to lead my country through that challenge. We cannot take risks anymore. I want to see a Kenya that says to our talented and young entrepreneurs and business people, we will give you more incentives and more opportunity than ever before to develop the skills of your workers and create Kenyan jobs and Kenyan wealth in the new African and global economy. A Kenya in which healthcare is a right, not a privilege. A Kenya that is at peace with its neighbors. A Kenya that takes our pride of place among the community of civilized states. A Kenya with a strong military, ready and able to use force where necessary to protect and defend our people and our interests when and where necessary. We all know that our tourism industry is literally on its knees. And the reason was our military, following the decision of the National Security Council, decided to walk into Somalia in pursuit of what I say, the doctrine of hot pursuit, which is acceptable under international law. And this was because a tourist was killed, a French old lady was killed somewhere near Lamu. And since then, we have seen a serious decline of tourism. Of course, we must congratulate Kenyans for doing domestic tourism. And I know all of them at about this time, Christmas time, they all go down and be able to occupy those Kenyan hotels. But we have work to do. And Jubilee are not able to tackle this challenge of decline in the fortunes of our tourism industry. At the weekend, the president said his government would pursue a motion in the National Assembly to disengage from the International Criminal Court. For what, Mr. President, I ask? It is these kinds of statements that alienate us from the community of civilized states. It is a retrogressive move. It is endorsing impunity. It is embracing the rule of the jungle. It must sincerely not happen in Kenya. And in fact, I do call on all African leaders to desist from pursuing this kind of action. I have followed this matter keenly, and I have a lot of respect for President Zuma of South Africa. I want to call on President Zuma to reconsider the notice that South Africa issued to the United Nations Secretary General Ban Ki-moon, giving notice that South Africa wishes to move away from the Rome Statute. It is easily understandable why President Nkurunziza of Burundi would want to pull away from the ICC. It is even easy to understand why Gambia under President Jammeh, you look at that president and you can easily understand why it is easy for Gambia to give notice. The rest of Africa remains united. And I want to tell you this, that whereas, and for those of you interested in international law, it is the right of every nation to withdraw from the Rome Statute under Article 127 of that treaty. But I want to say that unless we have a system, a local system, that you'll be able to deal with impunity. Crimes against humanity are listed as crimes against serious crimes. The crime of genocide has happened in Rwanda. And the president and the crime taking place in the month of January. And I can understand why Russia wants also to encourage people to move away from the Rome Treaty, because the crime of aggression is also listed as an international crime, tribal under the Rome Statute. To my brothers and sisters in the opposition, and please hear me, that we do carry the hopes and dreams and aspirations of millions of our people spread across every corner of this republic, working, some of them, others even studying abroad. These Kenyans struggle every day with the burden of the maladministration under Jubilee. We must save our people. We must save our country. We must secure the destiny of future generations. Now, we must come together and dispassionately agree on a single presidential candidate for the 2017 elections. A candidate who is acceptable in all corners of the country, and one who will decisively vanquish Jubilee from power. Allow me to tell you what I've personally gone through, and I thank my brother Raila for the example given of Job, in the book of Job. And I'm sure you do know that I hold dear some of these biblical truths. I was ready to be president of this country in 2002 when my brother Raila, in welcoming President Kibaki, simply asked a question, Sianatosha, and that became a declaration. I had to bite the bullet. I remember we went to the Hilton Hotel, my brother Raila, just jogging your memory. And there I see, mimi niko tayari to bite the bullet. And biting the bullet, I did. But I went everywhere and said, mimi singatuki, siwezi kutingizika. Some of my friends were shaken. Brother Wycliffe, you remember that story. They even threatened you as when you were fighting for the first Kano vice chairmanship. Yeah, vice chairman, Mheshimiwa Uhuru Kenyatta, there was no Kano in Central Province, so he had no challenge. There was a lot of opposition from Eastern Province. And I was here in this same hall on the 18th of March, 2002, when I was proposed as a vice chair representing the Eastern region. And our friend Haron Mwau was proposed and he did not get a seconder. And we went on to beat President Moi's deadline. I announced my candidature on the 30th of June, 2002. And of course, the Rainbow team linked up with the National Alliance Party of Kenya under Mwai Kibaki, our late brother, Wamalwa, and sister Charity Bill. And the country was re-energized. I shelved my ambition. We fought together, brother Raila, against a bad draft of the constitution. Because you say the bananas were banana republic. And the birth of the orange movement, the movement that has represented change. And even as I speak to you today, we only had to change the name Wiper from Orange Democratic Party of Kenya, because our friends were Limiliki ODM, and there was a lot of confusion. Had we known what was lying ahead, there probably would have been no need even to have ODM Kenya and ODM and Wiper at this stage. But we are, in terms of ideology, political philosophy, one team. We went on to lose. We defeated Jubilee, or the type of Jubilee that time, because of the bad draft constitution, and we restored dignity in due process. The only time the Electoral Commission did the correct job was in 2002, when we elected Kibaki as president, and in 2005, during the orange and the banana struggle for a new constitution. Thereafter, it has been a big joke. What am I saying? It has been 10 years postponement, perhaps more than 10 years. If I bit my bullet in 2002, in 2007, we were divided. We went and faced Kibaki divided. We were vanquished. But you remember, Kenyans, that I stood there before Brother Raila joined us. We formed the first coalition and then the Grand Coalition. And it is a Grand Coalition that has started all the projects you see that Jubilee are now pretending that they are their projects. As I said, the only project Jubilee have managed to do is actually the laptop project. And we have seen more universities say now they lack the capacity. There may be some feeble attempt at giving people laptops. And even the matter of rural electrification and the Kenya Rural Electrification Authority, the Grand Coalition government left this country at 70% in terms of connectivity to our primary schools. And what Jubilee have done is simply to try and complete. But ladies and gentlemen, I ask you a question. I even once said I'm ready to die for a brother. That was during the 20th anniversary of celebrating my membership to Parliament representing Mwingi North constituents. I want now to say it is time for sacrifice. It is time for real sacrifice. And I want to challenge my brothers in the opposition that this time round, I remember one time telling my friend Raila, we must negotiate tough with NAK. And it was like driven by the kind of change, because you have this habit in Kenya, we start something and then before we realize where we are all into a ditch. Trying to come out of it, some of you get branded. This time, at age 63, I, Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka, do not want to be called a watermelon again. Munanisikiliza jameni? Munanisikiliza? Si afadhali wengine waige mfano ambao mimi wenyewe nimeonyesha kutokuwa na binafsi. It used to be said Kalonzo Musyoka hawezi kuachia mtu. Nilimwachia ndugu Raila sikumwachia. Nilimwachia sikumwachia. Tulimsaidia Kibaki ama hatukumsaidia? Man, I'm not saying that I cannot sacrifice more. I am ready to sacrifice. But this time, you cannot stop that which God has purposed. Hear me, Kenyans. Hear me, Kenyans. If we want to deliver real change, my colleagues in the opposition, if we want to really deliver real change, the message from Kasarani today, from Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka, will thank you sincerely for overwhelmingly endorsing me as your presidential candidate. The message from here is that we now must all be selfless. Selfless. I will not take anything that is pretense. I have seen enough pretense in this country. I have seen enough betrayal in this country. Ndugu Raila and I have been betrayed. We have been betrayed. Therefore, we must change tact. We must change that. That's my message. If we want to deliver the change, the long-awaited change that has invaded this country, I say this almost with tears in my eyes. Let us not play games with politics anymore. If there's one thing Zemoy said, for which I give him credit, is when he said, siasa ni maisha, na siasa mbaya, maisha bila shaka nakuwa mabaya. Wakenya tumeona maisha mabaya hatujayaona. Wangapi wako tayari tupeleke Jubilee nyumbani? Basi ukitoka hapa ujue kwamba mimi Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka niko tayari, niko gangari, Nico, prepare. Mwananchi Mkenya, nimekufeel. Na tubonge. Nasikiza. Let's talk. I am listening. Are you listening too? I will be very proud to serve you, fellow Kenyans, without fear or favor. And if you have been critical of Jubilee, it is because they have been critical of themselves in the first place. It looks therefore to me that the next government is in this stadium, in this historic gymnasium today. And may God bless Kenya. May God bless every corner of our republic. May God give us grace even to forgive each other. Ukweli usemwe, yale maradhi yaliyokumba Kenya hii baada ya uchaguzi wa 2007-2008, maafa yaliyokumba nchi hii, kutoelewana ambako kulidhihika wazi, mimi najua kwamba hata leo bado watu wanaumwa, wa Kenya hawajaketi, na ndio tunasema truth, justice and reconciliation. This happened in South Africa. In order to bring this country together, we must be able to look at each other in the face and say, this time round, Kalonzo Musyoka apatiwe jameni. I heard my friend Uhuru yesterday say, after the next election, those who lose can go to court. And we know that Jubilee are in power today by virtue of a very contentious Supreme Court ruling. We don't want to go that way. Therefore, we want a free, fair, credible, transparent election. If you want peace, you must believe in delivering justice. I think my friend Uhuru will go down in history as a fantastic president when he accepts to hand over power peacefully, having agreed never again to preside over stolen elections in this country. These are the truths. Mungu abariki zaidi. Na mimi mwenyewe namwamini Mungu, najua kwa pamoja nasi. Na mniombe. Matatizo ni mengi, lakini Mungu akiwa mbele, bila shaka tutashinda. I don't want to leave anybody in doubt today. I don't want to leave you to leave Kasarani in any doubt today that Kalonzo is determined to become the next president of the Republic of Kenya. God bless you.
Our principal, Musalia Mudavadi Njoo Tafadhali, will invite Baba aje hapa kwa sababu Waipa wamesema ni...
Ni kinara wa Waipa, Kalonzo Musyoka hapo, akiwa anatoa hotuba yake.